And is the climate change threat real?
Climate scientists are telling you it's not warming to the degree predicted. In fact, it hadn't really warmed at all in the last 15 years.
You keep hearing that 2014 has been the warmest year on record. I asked the chair, you know what this is? It's a snowball. And that's just from outside here. So it's very, very cold out.
Does climate change occur? Yeah. Yes, of course we have climate change. We've had climate change forever. Is human involvement involved? Yes, it is. What extent? I don't know.
I do not think the science clearly supports the global warming theory. So I would not support any of that sort of cap and tax legislation.
There has been an increase in the surface temperature of the planet over the course of the last 100 years or so. I think it's clear that that has happened. The extent to which that has been caused by human activity, I think, is not as clear.
For the last 17 years, there has been no significant recorded warming. None. And the problem is the satellites, when they're measuring the temperature, it's not happening.
I'm keeping an open mind about the science of all of this, but, you know...
Are you convinced that climate change is man-made?
Well, I don't know that that is a resolved issue in science today.
I would hope my colleagues would devote more of their time trying to find real solutions for the American people instead of trying to please their liberal base with alarmist rhetoric about climate change.
The truth is, climate's always changing. It's always been changing, and it will continue to change. What percentage of it is due to human activity? I don't know the answer to, and scientists don't know the answer to the exact amount of it that's due to human activity.
I barely made it back here because of a May snowstorm in Wyoming. It got 18 inches in Cheyenne. It's a little hard to convince Wyoming people there's global warming.
No, I absolutely do not believe that, the science of man-caused climate change is proven, not by any stretch of imagination.
In this video, Bernie Sanders heavily suggests that Republicans deny climate change because they are funded by the fossil fuel industry. And he's right. And it's the same reason most Democrats don't seriously attempt to combat climate change either, and only pay lip service to the issue. I've said this before, and let me say it again. Money in politics is one of, if not the biggest issue that we face in America today. Money in politics has enabled the wealthy to buy politicians and elections. And unfortunately, they do. A lot. And they do so by funneling huge sums of money into the political process in order to get their way. And the lobbying done by those in the fossil fuel industry is a prime example of this. Did you know that according to a recent report, those in the fossil fuel industry have spent $2 billion since 2000 to prevent U.S. action in regards to combating climate change? And it is absolutely appalling because the scientific community has made it loud and clear that we need to combat climate change and that we need to combat it now. Otherwise, scientists believe there will be catastrophic consequences, for instance, in terms of natural disasters such as floods, droughts, wildfires, and the list goes on and on. And we cannot allow this to happen. People's lives are at stake. So many people's lives. This isn't some game. And that's why it's so appalling to see people in the fossil fuel industry spend so much money as a means to stop us from combating climate change. Apparently, these people believe their short-term profits are worth more than our people and our planet, but they're not. Again, this is not some game. Climate change is real, and it is a major threat to our people and our planet. And it doesn't seem as if we have much time left to act. We need to start taking this seriously. We need to convert our energy system to 100% clean renewable energy, and we need to do it now.